Today there is a hearing on a UFA-PBA bill to restore real disability benefits for firefighters and police officers in New York City. The mayor also has a bill that he thinks solves the problem. It doesn't. The speaker and the mayor's team called us on Wednesday at 11 o'clock to tell us they were having a hearing today, Friday at 10 a.m. There's a complete lack of transparency taking place behind us, despite the fact that they say the exact opposite is happening. The mayor's bill was never discussed with me or Pat or anybody as it applies to what our thoughts were on his proposal. His proposal is completely, wholly unacceptable and doesn't solve the real issue, which is firefighters and police officers need to know if they're permanently injured in the line of duty that their family will be taken care of. What they have offered doesn't even come close to that. The real solution is the real disability package that firefighters and police officers have always enjoyed and we lost in 2009. That's what we want back. That's what we deserve. That's our clear, concise message. We've been asking for this hearing for almost a year. We've had a supermajority in the council supporting our resolution, Liz Crowley's resolution, for, well, 4 months now. And they have their own rules that say 60 days and you get your hearing. We didn't get our hearing. That's all on them. It's all on the mayor, it's all on the speaker, it is not on us. It still can be resolved, but they do have to act quick. Governor Patterson, who vetoed Tier 2 legislation, has admitted that he did not know the disability component was going to be part of that. He made that change without consulting with us. He thought, based on comments he's made, that he thought the savings was needed on how long you have to work to get a pension, but he did not know the disability component was going out the window with it also. So he's on our side also. The actuary, Bob North, admitted that he took the 10 previous years after 9/11, made his projections going forward based on that. Those numbers are absolutely not acceptable because of 9/11. Thousands and thousands of firefighters and police officers were permanently disabled because of that toxic stew that we worked in for a year. Unless this administration believes there's going to be another 9/11 tomorrow, they don't get to count those numbers and use them against us. It's not real. The actuary has admitted that technically the numbers work, but that even he said, as he was retiring, police officers and firefighters should have real three-quarter disability protection.
This is an issue and a moral obligation that that city has had for 75 years and has let drop. The mayor came up with a proposal that does not do it. It's nothing but a press release. We're honorable people that serve the citizens of this city and put ourselves at risk each and every day, including while we stand here. This council, Albany, the mayor, have an obligation to keep that moral pact that the citizens have. Work now, put yourself at risk. If you're disabled, we'll help you take care of your family.
We are here today to also hear a bill from the mayor, which takes a bad, bad system and makes it worse. How can our administration stand up for an increase in minimum wage, but turn their backs on our uniform workers? The benefits our uniform responders receive are not enough right now to give them peace of mind that when they risk their lives fighting for our city, that our city will look out for them.
Every day, firefighters, police officers risk their lives. Every day when they go to work, no one knows if they're going to come home. So how can we separate how much money people get when they're doing the same thing? And I say to the mayor, please, people are people. There's no differential in who they are. They deserve the same benefits that people prior got. So let's give it to them.
There's no one who served this city more admirably than our firefighters, than our police officers. And if we value them in the way that we say we value them, we need to compensate them in accordance with that. We need to compensate them not just when they are actively going in the buildings and saving lives and on the front line and saving lives, but when because of the job that they have done. They have been put in harm's way, and they are now disabled and unable to perform those duties. We especially need to compensate them properly at that time.
Each day that goes by, it's going to get harder and harder to get done. And the other gentleman asked a question about me consulting. As the chairman of the committee, both in the Assembly and the Senate, no one was consulted from the mayor's office on the bill. And the other question that you asked, the controller, how much is the difference between the Assembly bill and the Senate bill and the mayor's bill? Scott's going to try to do it, but the mayor's numbers are not real. And my problem is with the mayor putting in a bill last week, he's running out the clock. And as Councilwoman Crowley said, it's an outrage what's going on with this administration. Going around the country saying he's looking for a $15 minimum wage for workers in the city and will not give more than $27 or $30 to an injured police or fireman for the whole day.
Equity should apply to firefighters and police officers. Income inequality should apply to our men and women who keep our city strong and who keep our streets safe. It's as simple as that. Because when a bullet comes their way, no one asks the question when you were hired. When you're caught in a fire, no one asks the questions when you were hired. We should treat them all the same. Discrimination will not be tolerated. I say one simple message. Move the bill.
Bottom line is there cannot be two classes of heroes. There's one class of heroes. And we have got to stop playing politics with the lives of our fire and our police officers. And so what I would say today is you got to get it together, folks. You got to take the politics out of this. You got to pass bills. And you got to make our folks whole. Because that matters to the safety on our streets. But it also matters to the family.